Hey guys, Murkeebs here. So this is gonna be a bit of a different video. Yuzu Keycaps reached out and asked if I wanted to try and design my own custom keycap set, using their brand new keycap configurator tool. But before anything else, you should know that no money changed hands and all thoughts and opinions about the service and end product are always my own. So with that being said, let's play around with the configurator. Okay, so here we are on Yuzu Keycaps' website. And before we get to play around with the configurator, first we'll need to select a layout for our set. You're free to pick from a lot of common and some uncommon layouts, from normal layouts like full-sized, TKL, 75% and 65%, to other more niche and normally more difficult to hit layouts like 40%, ortholinear, or split ergo. For this video, and just to keep it simple, I'll just be going with 75%. Now the first thing we'll be messing with is the keycap kitting. By default, the kitting is set up with a standard ANSI enter key, a 6.25U size spacebar, and 1U size modifier keys. Then depending on your use case for your keycap set, you can choose whether or not you want to go for an ISO enter key, a split left shift key, a 7U spacebar bottom row, 1.25U sized right side mods, a split backspace key, and a step caps lock key. Then if you want to get a few more keycaps as add-ons, like a few extra keycaps to cover a 7U spacebar, or a numpad, you can order those along with your kit for a few extra dollars on top of the base price. Then once you're set with your layout, now comes the really fun part. Picking your colors. For me, this is a bit overwhelming because you're really free to pick just about any keycap combination of colors you want. Price doesn't change no matter how many different colors you pick. You can change the keycap colors on a per key basis like I'm doing here, or if you want to take it the easy way, you can customize it in groupings, like messing with alphas, mods, and accents entirely separately. Now I'm honestly not the most creative when it comes to color combination, so this is really something you need to play around with over on Yuzu's website. Anyways, once you've decided on your colors, you can start messing around with the legending and the labels. Now when it comes to the labels, you're free to pick between a whole bunch of these different keyboard layouts depending on your use case. Normally, most regular keycap base kits just come in a regular QWERTY layout. But say for example, you're someone that needs region-specific keycap labels. So you can pick between adding extra characters to cover a German layout, a UK layout, a French layout, a Swedish layout, and many, many more. But that isn't all you can do. You can also choose whether or not you want your keycaps to have sub-legends. Like for example, Cyrillic characters, Korean Hangul, Japanese Hiragana, Japanese Katakana, Arabic sub-legends, and many more. Then something super neat is you can even tweak the keycaps labeling. So for example, you can tweak the return key and rewrite it to say enter. Or you can even change it to something entirely different. Then there's also a large selection of different icons for you to choose from, and you can reposition the icon wherever you like. So for example, if you don't want your delete key to say delete, you could replace it with a different icon. In this case, let's change it to a trash can. Basically making your own novelty keycaps. The only real limit is your imagination. And of course, the surface area of the keycap. Next, say you're not exactly happy with the default typeface and want to change it to something to fit your taste better. Well, the configurator lets you choose from a wide variety of fonts. From something basic like Nonito, to something retro like 8-Bit Wonder, or something more RPG themed like Dragonfire. You're really spoiled for choice here. And that's pretty much it for a surface level look at the configurator. I would honestly go over everything else the configurator offers, but then this video would go on for way too long. So I highly recommend checking out Yuzu Keycaps' configurator linked in the video description down below. Now as far as pricing is concerned, it does scale based on the layout you choose, so you'll need to check how much it'll cost you over on the site. For a 75% layout like I made, base cost without any extra keycaps starts at $85, and international shipping costs a flat rate of $15. Then once you're happy with your set, all that's left to do is add it to your cart and check out. Manufacturing should take about 3 to 10 days. Then Yuzu Keycaps will email you a photo of the produced set, just so you can check if the kitting is exactly how you configured it before they ship it out. Then once you're happy with how your keycaps came out, you'll receive a tracking number and shipping should take roughly 7 to 14 days. Now for me to fully showcase what this configurator is capable of doing, rather than making a pretty plain and simple looking base kit, I decided to try using as many colors as I could. I had a little help and made a set that I like to call PBT Clown, inspired by one of my favorite keycap sets, GMK Greg. I'll leave the config ID for this set in the video description down below. And now with the keycap set finally in hand, now for the unboxing. Taking a look at the box the keycaps come in, it's pretty basic with some Yuzu Keycaps branding on the front, back, and sides. And opening up the box, the keycaps are safely packed in these plastic trays with the exact kitting you put together in the configurator. No more, no less. Yuzu is working together with experienced keycap manufacturer Curative to produce these sets, and as far as quality is concerned, there's honestly no need to worry. Taking a close look at the keycaps, these are a high-quality dye-sublimated 1.5mm thick PBT plastic set in cherry profile. The keycap surface is super smooth without any rough texture whatsoever, making it really comfortable to the fingertips. For a dye sub PBT set, I'm pretty surprised with just how vibrant and colorful the keycap colors turned out. The print quality is overall pretty nice and plenty sharp with minimal fuzziness. And upon taking a closer look, there's a very teeny tiny, negligible amount of tech skewing, tilt, and distortion within the keycap comfort grooves, but it isn't super noticeable in regular use. And now here's a quick typing test of the keycaps mounted on a board, then I'll give my final thoughts on the product right after. Now, full transparency, while Yuzu Keycaps did provide this set free of charge for review, I honestly think that $100 for a set that you customize yourself to fit your specific board is a fair price to pay, at least for a 75% layout. Of course, cheaper would always be better, but $100 does seem like a pretty decent deal to me, because with the provided configurator, you're free to select as many colors as you like, tweak as many labels as you like, and really craft a keycap set to fit your own personal taste and aesthetic. A lot of the time, you'd still need to buy a keycap base kit for over $100, and to get any extra international or accent kitting, you would still need to fork over a few more tens or sometimes even $100 more just to fully kit out a set. You don't get this level of customizability with commercially available keycaps, so you're really getting your money's worth here. At least by making your own set, you're guaranteed the exact amount of keys you need, the colors you want, and really dial in the aesthetic you're after. With the only con being that you really can't repurpose the keycaps on a different build unless they share the exact same layout. One thing I'm really hoping for is if Yuzu Keycaps lets you play around with a full base kit, so you can basically create your own one-off keycap set. But for now it seems pretty limited and layout dependent. Anyways, to wrap things up, overall I really think Yuzu Keycaps is a great value for money if you really want to take customizing your board to the next level. Since I'm sure everyone in this hobby has always wanted to create and design their own custom keycap set. So with that being said, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, please drop a like and leave a comment as these videos take a lot of work. And if you want to see more content just like this, please consider subscribing. It would really mean a lot. I'll be leaving all relevant links in the video description down below. Thank you guys for watching. Till next time, Merkeebs out.